Hi, I'm Bob Berry, and today we're going to talk about boom deflection and shock loading. Some of the basic functions of a crane include lifting and lowering a load and swinging a load in a horizontal motion. However, when these functions are applied improperly, catastrophic failure of the crane structure may result. A crane lifts a load by distributing the weight of the load along the structure. This redistribution of the weight is called a compression load. As the load is applied to the structure, the potential energy of the boom increases. As the crane lowers a load, the potential energy is slowly released as the load is landed. Cranes are designed to lift loads that are free from the ground and unobstructed. When a load is attached to the ground or a supporting structure, the compression load is substantially increased. This results in a potential energy many times in excess of the crane's safe working load and may cause the boom to buckle or fail or explode in some cases. Furthermore, if the load suddenly breaks free of the ground or supporting structure, the quick release of potential energy will result in a shock load applied to the structure. It may also cause a catastrophic failure of the structure. When lifting and removing poles or objects partially buried, it is very important to dig around the object so it may be lifted freely. The surrounding soil around the base of the pole creates suction and applies forces which add to the weight of the load. In addition, any concrete or material used to secure the pole in the ground must be identified and calculated as part of the load weight, or removed to reduce the weight of the load. It is also important to remember that the swing functions of a crane are not designed to pull or break free objects attached to the ground or in a structure. The swing function of a crane should only be used to horizontally move a freely suspended load. The boom of a crane is intended to support a vertical compression load only. When the swing function of a crane is used to pull a load in a horizontal manner, side loading occurs and again will result in catastrophic failure of the structure. As a reminder, it is never safe to exceed the safe working capacity of a crane as defined by the load chart. There is no such thing as a safety factor in addition to the capacities listed in the load chart. Although exceeding the load chart capacities may not always result in immediate tipping or structural failure to the crane, serious damage can occur to other components of the crane, such as the hoist line or the boom. And remember, proper planning, proper training, and good communication always makes for a safe lift. Look for our next Sims Crane Minute coming soon.